Hi everyone. Today I am reading from a column I wrote in November 1981. Yes, it's time for Thanksgiving. Is it time for Thanksgiving already? The calendar says it is, and so do grocery store advertisements. I'm not sure I'm prepared for the big one-day celebration. Sure, I think we have something to be thankful for. In fact, we have a lot to be thankful for. That's not the reason I'm not ready. It's just that I've been being thankful for our blessings throughout the year. One day is too short a time for all a whole year's worth of thanking. I started out the year being grateful our winter wasn't too harsh. We weren't trapped inside too often, yet there was enough snow to keep the kids sledding. Robbie and Becky were especially thankful for that. My husband was also glad the wood lasted the season to keep our family's winter nest warm. Then winter ended and another prayer went heavenward. As April appeared, our family opened its arms to spring. Even the most devoted snow slider was ready for the sweet smell of crocuses and freshly turned soil. This season of renewal is one for a lot of prayers, both asking and thanking. We ask tons of favors each year, not to be greedy, just productive, useful farmers. So, to farm, we need seed, fuel, machinery, working machinery, and capital. We also need land and each other. A silent prayer goes out when each one of these farming tools is gathered and ready for planting. There sure is no use waiting until November to do all that thanking. We might forget by then. Weather prayers are in a category all by themselves. They are unique to the time of year and the needs. This year, we weren't sure we were on the right wavelength with our weather prayers. Spring started out with nice dry weather for field work. We got this gift and said a quick thank you, God, for that blessing. During planting season, there isn't time to dally over anything, even prayers. And the Almighty understands. He knows there's time we will be thanking Him properly, which we did. Spring rains came, but luckily no storms. So thin gray green lines traveled down the fields of dark soil as the plants poke through the soil. Another thank you. Then rain stopped. July became a month of asking prayers. The future of our green babies looked pretty grim, but we didn't give up, and one day rain saved them and us. That water from heaven couldn't have been more beautiful if it was rose water scented. It rated a big thank you. Now our harvest is over. The crops are settled in storage in the fields, and the fields are ready for spring. It wasn't our biggest or best harvest, but again, it was ours. We didn't wait for November to say we were grateful, happy, and pleased with this year on the farm. That's a daily chore, as are many farm jobs that have to be done again and again and again. Thanksgiving Thursday will just be another day out on our farm. We will be thankful to God again for the good days and the bad days, because without the bad, we wouldn't be able to appreciate the good as we should. So that was 1981. And I think it could be just about any year, except for maybe the weather problems. They change from day to day. The good and the bad. I hope you are grateful for all that you have. And come back again to join me for another reading of my archives from my column Words in My Pocket. Until then.